This is the game Hungry Numbers. In this game, you set up a row of numeral cards and then match different dot cards to their corresponding numeral card. This is a really fun game that helps kids recognize how written numerals connect to quantities. In this case, quantities of dots. To start, we'll use the 0 to 3 numeral cards and the 0 to 3 dice and 10 frame cards. But if you want to increase the challenge level, you can play this game with more types of dot cards and with higher quantities of dots. To play Hungry Numbers, first, lay out the numeral cards in order. You can have children organize the cards, or you can do it to start. When watching children arrange the cards, notice if they recognize the numerals, and if they know the order the cards go in. Give them time to figure it out before you jump in to help. Then you can say, these numbers are hungry, but they only eat cards that have the same number of dots as their numeral. So we're gonna feed the matching dot cards to the numeral cards. Then shuffle your dot cards and say, let's look at the top card in the pile. How many dots are there? Yes, there are 2 dots. 1, 2. Let's put this card above the numeral 2 card to be eaten. Where does this one go? Yes, okay, 3. Keep feeding those hungry numbers until all the dot cards in the pile have been eaten. As you play this game, you might notice children using a skill called subitizing. Subitizing is our ability to quickly recognize quantities. It's an important skill for kids to practice because it helps form a foundation for basic math skills. Some kids will be able to immediately recognize and sort dot quantities 0 through 3. But with 4 or higher, they may need to count the dots one by one. And that's because we naturally subitize smaller numbers, like 2 and 3. But the more dots there are, the harder it is to subitize. This game helps children connect what they're counting to written number symbols. They begin to understand how quantities, in this case quantities of dots, relate to counting words and to written numerals. You can also get creative with this game and use the numeral cards to label plates, baskets, or other containers and have kids feed the dot cards into the containers. In the classroom, you can even use Hungry Numbers as a transition activity. You can give each child one dot card and have them feed it to its matching numeral card before leaving the circle or table. Check out our website for more games and lots of other ways to learn and practice math.